Hello, in this video I will try to explain how to create a custom mask for SentiMask SDK. For this purpose I have created a template 3D model that you can download and use it as a reference. You can find a download link in the description of this video. This model has a simple texture with basic UV layout. I have marked some areas on texture to make things easier. Now I will make a copy of texture image, material file and 3D model itself. I will use GIMP to draw a new texture. First of all, I will open template texture in GIMP. I will use it as a reference. Since now is 2018, a year of Winter Olympic Games, I want to make a mask with an Olympic Games logo as if it was painted on a face. For this purpose, I will import the logo and oil paint texture for a background image. I'm not an artist or a designer, and I am not so good at drawing, but I will try my best. However, this video is just to show a basic workflow. I will not get into details what I am doing. I am just aligning the logo by resizing it, rotating and moving to the desired position. Just adding or duplicating the layers. Playing around with opacity. I also added some color to the lips, just to show that you can use our reference texture as a guide. I deleted some parts of background texture around the face using soft brush. Finally, I have exported the created texture mask as a mask.png file with alpha channel. The final texture looks like this. Now, I want to rename the material file to mask.mtl and 3D object file to mask.obj. Now, if I open our 3D model, we see that it has some issues. It has no textures, so we need to modify 3D model itself. Our model is just a simple text file. So I will open it with a text editor and change the line that says sentimasktemplate.mtl to mask.mtl. In similar way, I will edit the material file, replacing sentimasktemplate.png with mask.png. Now, if I open our 3D model, we see that it has texture on it. You can see some black areas around the face. It is because that the 3D viewer that I am using does not support transparency. Now select our texture image, material and model files and copy them in SentiMask sample bin folder. Now, if I will run the sample, you will see our default face mask that we distribute together with our sample. As you can see, it is the same 3D face model with a very simple texture. To make the sample work with newly created texture, we need to modify the source code of the sample. Go to Samples, SentiMask, C++, and open Visual Studio Solution. In main.c++ file, almost at the end of it, you will have to find and edit the line where the loading of 3D model is done. Just replace koanashi.obj with mask.obj and compile the sample. I am using 64-bit solution in release mode. After compiling is finished, go back to the sample bin folder. Now let's run the sample. Now let's open our mask image in GIMP and edit it one more time. I want to delete almost half of the face mask and make it even more transparent, just to show how it will affect the final result. Because playing around with transparency, you can achieve good and interesting results. Now save our mask and run sample once again to see the final result. I hope this video was helpful and thank you for watching it.